Good morning, students. In our previous session, we have read page number 16 and 17 of chapter Fritz and understood Jayanto's obsession with Fritz. We also understood how Fritz was destroyed and also the mystery of the Deodar tree was unfolded. So by the end of this video, you will be able to learn more about Jayanto's childhood memories. And you will also learn about some mysterious and eerie elements in the story. So let us start reading of page number 18. Jayanto still sounded doubtful. I said, "Who do you think is I, children?" "It is Shankar, that is the narrator." I said, "Didn't you see anything after you switched the light on?" "Nothing." So in reply to this question, Jayanto replies that he did not see anything. "But then, I did not switch it on immediately after opening the eyes. To tell you the truth, I felt rather scared at first. But when I did switch it on, there was nothing to be seen." So when Jayanto opens his eyes to see if there was anything, he did not find anything. That means whatever came in must still be in the room. This line is spoken by Shankar. So Shankar knows if anything has come in the room which has awakened Jayanto, then it must be in the room. "Well, since both the doors are bolted from inside." I rose quickly and searched under the bed. "Who is I again, children?" "It is Shankar." So Shankar got up and he searched under the bed. "Behind our suitcases and everywhere else in the room." I could not find anything. The door to the bathroom was also closed. I opened it and was about to start another search when Jayanto called out to me softly, "Shankar." So what does this para tell us, children? This paragraph tells us that Shankar got up to find out if there was still something in the room. He wanted to see what was there which has awakened Jayanto. So he started searching everywhere under the bed, under the suitcases and also everywhere else in the room. He did not find anything, so he opened the door of the bathroom. So as soon as he opened the door of the bathroom, he was called out by Jayanto. I came back to the room. Again, who is I? It is the narrator, Shankar. I came back to the room. Jayanto was staring hard at the cover of the quilt. What do you mean by staring? It means looking continuously. So Jayanto was looking continuously at the cover of the quilt. Upon seeing me, he pulled a portion of it near the lamp and said, "Look at this." So Jayanto wanted Shankar to see something on the quilt. I bent over the cloth and saw tiny brown circular marks on it. So yes, there was something on the quilt. It was some mark that was tiny and brown. So Shankar could conclude what it was. I said, "Well, these could have been made by a cat." Jayanto did not say anything. It was obvious that something had deeply disturbed him. But it was 2:30 in the morning. I simply had to get a little more sleep, or I know I would just keep feeling tired. Whose feelings are these? These are Shankar's feelings, right? And we had plans of doing a lot of sightseeing the following day. Now, as they were on a trip, they wanted to see various things, and therefore Shankar wanted to sleep so that he does not feel tired the next morning. So, after murmuring, underline the word murmuring, speaking softly. So after murmuring a few soothing words, underline the word soothing, means comforting words. So after murmuring a few soothing words such as, "Don't worry, I'm here with you," and who knows, those marks may have been on your quilt already when you went to the bed. So these were the soothing words Shankar said to Jayanto. And then, "I switched off the light once more and lay down." Then Shankar went to sleep again. I had no doubt that Jayanto had only had a bad dream. Now Shankar believed that it was Jayanto's bad dream. All those memories of his childhood had upset him, obviously, and that was what had led to his dreaming of walking on his chest. What was walking on his chest? That was a cat. So Shankar believed that Jayanto has had a dream of a cat walking on his chest. I slept soundly for the rest of the night. Who is I again? Shankar. So Shankar slept soundly for the rest of the night. If there were further disturbances, Jayanto did not tell me about them. But I could see in the morning that he had not slept well. So the last paragraph on page number 18 says that Jayanto could not sleep the whole night. Tonight I must give him one of the tranquilizers I brought with me, I thought. What do you mean by tranquilizers? Tranquilizers are the drugs to reduce anxiety. So Shankar had brought a tranquilizer and he thought that he would give it to Jayanto tonight. We finished our breakfast by 9 as we had planned and left for the fort. So they had planned the sightseeing at the fort. So they finished their breakfast and they went for the fort. A car had already been arranged. It was almost 9:30 by the time we reached. Some of Jayanto's old forgotten memories began coming back again. As Jayanto had been to this place earlier, so he started recalling his memories. Though, fortunately, they had nothing to do with his doll. Now, these were not the memories of his doll. Those were other memories. In fact, his youthful exuberance, underline the word exuberance, excitement, made me think he had forgotten all about it. So Jayanto looked excited, which made Shankar feel that he had forgotten about his doll. There's that elephant on the top of the gate, he exclaimed. So he had remembered that on the top of the gate there was an elephant. And the turrets. Turrets are small towers. And here is the bed made of silver and throne. These are all his memories, which he is relating to now. Look at the picture on the wall. I saw it the last time. So he was excited telling Shankar about his childhood memories and he was reliving those memories. But within an hour, his enthusiasm began to wane. Underline the word wane, children. It means it started declining, getting less. I was so engrossed. Underline the word engrossed, children. Engrossed means to hold complete interest. So Shankar was very much engrossed with himself and he did not notice anything at first. He did not notice that Jayanto had lost his enthusiasm. But while walking through a hall and looking at the chandeliers, underline the word chandeliers, children, it means a large decorated light that hangs from ceiling. But while walking through a hall and looking at the chandeliers hanging from the ceiling, I suddenly realized that Jayanto was no longer walking by my side. Where was he? While he was walking, he did not know that Jayanto had already gone. And he suddenly realized that Jayanto was not walking by his side. So where was he? We had a guide with us. Now for the sightseeing, they had hired a guide. And he told, Babu has gone on the terrace. Right? So he said that Babu here refers to Jayanto has gone out on the terrace. I came out of the hall. Who is I, children, again? I refers to Shankar. I came out of the hall and found Jayanto standing absent-mindedly near a wall on the other side of the terrace. Now underline this line, children. Jayanto standing absent-mindedly near a wall on the other side of the terrace. This creates mysterious and eerie atmosphere. He did not seem to notice my presence even when I went and stood beside him. That means Jayanto was so engrossed in his thoughts that he did not notice Shankar coming and standing by his side. He started, underline the word started, he was shocked when I called him by his name. What on the earth is the matter with you? What on the earth is the matter with you means, what is your problem? I asked. Who asked it? It was Shankar who asked. Why are you standing here looking morose? Underline the word morose, children. It means sad or sorrowful. So Shankar asked Jayanto why he was standing morose. Even in a beautiful place like this, I can't stand it. I can't stand it, children. It means I can't bear it. Now Shankar was getting irritated at this behavior of Jayanto. So he told him bluntly that he cannot bear it. Jayanto simply said, have you finished seeing everything? So what was Jayanto's reply to his answer? Have you finished everything? Have you seen everything? If so, let's. Now here, there are three dots which says that Jayanto did not complete his statement. Had I been alone, who is I again? It is Shankar. So Shankar feels that if he had been alone, I would definitely have spent a little more time at the fort. He would have spent more time at the fort. But one look at Jayanto made me decide in favor of returning to the circuit house. But as soon as he looked at Jayanto's face, he felt that it was better to go back to the circuit house. So that was all for page number 18 and 19, children. Reread these pages and underline the important words. Thank you.